you receive a medication order of 40 milligrams per kilogram of body weight. The available medication is 100 milligrams per milliliter. How many milliliters should you give an 8-pound, 4-ounce infant? To solve this problem, we'll be using proportions, which we see here below, where if the units of A and C are the same, and the units of B and D are the same, then A times D must equal B times C. To set up the first proportion, we'll use the rate 40 milligrams per kilogram of body weight. So we'll have 40 milligrams per 1 kilogram must equal the number of milligrams for the infant, which we'll call x milligrams, per the weight, which is given as 8 pounds, 4 ounces. Notice in this case, we cannot cross multiply and solve for x because we do not have the same units on the bottom. Here we have kilograms, and here we have pounds and ounces. So we'll first have to get a common unit here. We'll convert ounces to pounds, and then we'll convert the pounds to kilograms to finally solve for x. So we first want to convert 4 ounces to pounds. We may recognize this as 0.25 pounds, but if we don't, we can use the conversion, 16 ounces equals 1 pound, set up another proportion to convert 4 ounces to pounds. We can say that 16 ounces is to 1 pound as 4 ounces is to an unknown number of pounds, we'll call it y pounds. Notice in this case, the units on top and on the bottom are the same, so we can cross multiply and solve for y. When cross multiplying, we'll leave off the units, so 16 times y must equal 1 times 4, or 16y equals 4. If we divide both sides by 16, we have y equals 4 sixteenths, which does simplify to 1/4, which would be 0.25. Remember, to convert a fraction to a decimal, we divide. Notice 1 divided by 4 equals 0.25, and so does 4 divided by 16. Which means we can now write this as 8.25 pounds instead of 8 pounds, 4 ounces. But notice how we still have different units on the bottom. So now we'll convert pounds to kilograms. So for the next proportion, we'll use the conversion 2.2 pounds is approximately 1 kilogram. This will give us the first rate or ratio in our proportion. We can say that 2.2 pounds is to 1 kilogram as 8.25 pounds is to an unknown number of kilograms, we'll call it z kilograms. Again, notice how we have the same units on top, same units on the bottom, so we can cross multiply and solve for z. 2.2 times z must equal 1 times 8.25. So 2.2z equals 8.25. Divide both sides by 2.2. Z is equal to this quotient here, 8.25 divided by 2.2 is 3.75, which means 8.25 pounds is equal to 3.75 kilograms. So we finally can solve for x to determine the number of milligrams the infant needs, and then from there, we can determine the number of milliliters the infant needs. So we can say 40 milligrams is to 1 kilogram as x milligrams is to 3.75 kilograms. So notice finally we do have the same units on the top and on the bottom. Now we can cross multiply and solve for x. We would have 1 times x equals 40 times 3.75. Well, 1 times x would be x, and then we have 40 times 3.75, which will give us a number of milligrams the infant needs. So the infant needs 150 milligrams. And now we can use this information to determine the number of milliliters the infant needs. The medication comes in 100 milligrams per milliliter. So this will be one of the rates for our last proportion. We'll have 100 milligrams to 1 milliliter must equal the rate of 150 milligrams to an unknown number of milliliters. So 150 milligrams to, let's call it, to Q number of milliliters. Notice in this last proportion, we do have the same units on top and the same units on the bottom. So we can cross multiply and solve for Q to answer the final question. Q times 100 must equal 1 times 150. Well, 100Q equals 150. Divide both sides by 100. We would have Q equals, this would be 1.5, which means you give the infant 1.5 milliliters of medication. I hope you found this helpful.